kwa aliyekuwa mwalimu mkuu wa shule ya upili ya wasichana ya Ikasiri, Jane Muthoni, baada ya kumpata na kosa la mauaji ya mumewe Solomon Mwangi miaka 4 iliyopita. Solomon Mwangi alikuwa pia mwalimu mkuu wa shule ya upili ya Kiiru. Akitoa hukumu hiyo, hakimu mkuu Joel Ngoge ametoa pia kifungo sawa kama hicho kwa Isaac Nganga ambaye alikuwa ameshtakiwa pamoja na Jane Muthoni. Ngoge amesema kwenye hukumu yake kwamba amekadiria ombi la kutoa hukumu hii, huku akisema wawili hao wana siku 14 pekee kukata rufaa ya uamuzi huo.
The manner in which the deceased was killed is an aggravating factor. The deceased was stupefied to render him helpless. He was then manually strangled in two stages. First, inside the vehicle, and then at the ultimate site where his body was found. There is no question that the circumstances of this murder are indeed gravely aggravating. They call for a very stiff sentence to match the ruthlessness of the murder and its effects on the victims and the society. In this case, I have come to the conclusion that a stiff custodial sentence is merited as the only suitable way of expressing society's condemnation of the accused person's conduct or deter similar conduct in the future. Having considered all the mitigating circumstances and aggravating circumstances, I'm of the view that a custodial sentence of 30 years for each of the two accused persons is the appropriate sentence. Consequently, in my view, a fit sentence that properly balances the mitigating circumstances with the aggravating circumstances is a sentence of 30 years imprisonment for each of the two accused persons. And I, accordingly, sentence each of the accused persons to that period.
Na serikali ina